Lehigh and Lafayette. Saying those words together makes you think rivalry, history, legacy, and pride. The 149th meeting has all of those things and a little something more. It's Lehigh and Lafayette for the Patriot League Championship next. Absolutely perfect day in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania for the 149th edition of college football's most played rivalry. The tailgaters were out early this morning getting geared up for the Patriot League Championship, and a sellout crowd is on hand to watch two arch rivals battle to play on next weekend, as it's the 4-6 Lafayette Leopards taking on the 8-2 Lehigh University Mountain Hawks. Good afternoon and welcome to Goodman Stadium. I'm Steve Degler. This is always a big game regardless of records, but there is a lot more on the line here this afternoon as Lehigh and Lafayette meet for the 149th time. The winner captures the Patriot League Championship as both teams are 3-1 in league play, and the winner advances into the NCAA playoffs starting next weekend. Lehigh in search of its third league title in the last 4 years, while Lafayette looking for its first trophy since 2006. We welcome in former Lehigh linebacker Mike Yadish, a veteran of several of these games. And Mike, both coaches are very concerned about their teams leaving their energy either in the locker room or the practice field coming into the game today.
Yeah, the coaches in a game like this, they don't really have to worry about X's and O's. They got to worry about the mental state of the players, that they don't get too amped up and use all that energy in practice. Got to save some for today.
Well, both teams feature outstanding running backs. Lehigh has been known for its air attack over the years, but a lot more balance for the Mountain Hawks this year. And it starts with Keith Sherman.
Keith Sherman's been great for Lehigh ever since the injury to Brandon Bajakowski, Lehigh's starting quarterback. They needed to do something different. So what they do, they grab their senior captain, Keith Sherman, and he's just exploded the last several games, running the ball. He had a great game last week, a career high up at Hamilton, New York against Colgate. And Keith Sherman doesn't only do it with his legs, he also has good hands. Here you see him 2 weeks ago against Holy Cross, a little throwback screen. Keith Sherman down the sideline, 6 points for Lehigh. Now all of a sudden you got another Sherman on the other side of the field, Ross Sherman. He's a junior running back, number 29, has been starting since his freshman year for the Leopards. He needs to have a big game like he did last week in the upset win over Fordham. Also has good hands out of the backfield, and Ross Sherman will have a big day if Lafayette wants to win this ball game.
So both teams can certainly run the football, and they have outstanding guys out wide as well. For Lehigh, a guy who has really become the featured guy this year, it's wide receiver Lee Kerfus.
Lee Kerfus, number 80, has had a really, really good year. He was a little second fiddle to Ryan Spadola last year. This year, he's just exploded. He has one of the best hands you'll ever see play at this level. He leads the FCS in receiving yards per game. And not only does he have great hands in traffic, once he gets into the open space, he has really good speed to get into the end zone. On the other side, the mirror image for Lafayette. They've got a 6'3" senior, Mark Ross. He has just pretty much shattered every receiving record over there in Easton for Lafayette. Last year in this game, he had two touchdown catches, and Lafayette needs to keep Lehigh's defense off balance and get the ball to number 10, Mark Ross.
So we have a lot of experience in the backfield, a lot of experience out wide, but there won't be a whole lot of experience behind center today. Both teams going very young. In fact, for Lehigh, we'll see two quarterbacks. Junior Matt McHale gets just his second career start. We'll also see freshman Nick Schafnisky in there for the Mountain Hawks. And for Lafayette, it is Drew Reed getting his start today in the Lehigh-Lafayette game. The first freshman to start in this game for Lafayette since 2000. It's the Mountain Hawks and the Leopards. Opening kickoff comes your way right after this.
Welcome back to the 149th game between Lehigh and Lafayette. It's been a very interesting week here. Andy Cohen told me on Wednesday his football players were ready to play this game on Sunday. It's been the longest week of their lives, according to Lee Kerfus. These guys are geared up and ready to play for the 2013 Patriot League Championship.
All right, Troy, thank you very much. Great atmosphere, beautiful weather here this afternoon at Goodman Stadium. Lafayette at 4-6 on the season, Lehigh at 8-2, both 3-1 in the Patriot League. The winner will play next week in the playoffs. Frank Tavani is the head coach of the Leopards. He is in his 14th season in Easton, 75-81. His career mark, his team started 1-5 and has won 3 of its last 4 games. For Lehigh, Andy Cohen is in his 8th season as the head coach. He is 59-32. Mountain Hawks have won 2 of the last 3 Patriot League titles. They come in today winning 4 of their last 5 contests. Lehigh won the toss, elected to defer its choice until the second half. So freshman Ryan Pandy will kick off for the Mountain Hawks. Lafayette very good in the kick return game, including Ross Sherman, who is back deep along with Matt Smalley. Smalley has returned 2 kickoffs for touchdowns already this season. Lehigh in brown, Lafayette in white. The 149th meeting is underway from Bethlehem. High end-over-end kick, Ross Sherman at the 10-yard line. Gets across the 25, makes a move at the 30, still on his feet as he nears midfield. Sherman into Lehigh territory, tripped up by Oliver Rigo inside the 35-yard line. A 58-yard kickoff return for Ross Sherman.
Big game like this where teams are even, you have a lot of special team plays could decide the game. And look at the hole open up right in the middle, and then a quick move. Ross Sherman uses some speed, gets to the outside in Lehigh territory.
Lafayette averages roughly 26 yards per kickoff return, among the best in the country. And there is Sherman going 58 yards to give the Leopards a 1st-and-10 at the Lehigh 32-yard line. The freshman quarterback is Drew Reed. He has completed 74% of his passes. 4 of his 5 interceptions came last week in the win over Fordham. Reed, 6 feet tall, 185 pounds from Lakeland, Tennessee. Sherman is the tailback. Play action on first down, over the middle, wide open to the tight end, Brandon Hall, who is down inside the 5-yard line.
Couldn't ask for a better start if you're Frank Tavani in the Leopard offense. Big kick return, play action first down, hits the tight end right across the middle. First and goal on the 5 for the Leopards.
27-yard pickup, 24th catch of the year for Hall, who is a gigantic target at 6'7", 244 pounds. Some NFL teams have requested film on Hall. Reed again out of the shotgun. Ross split out, top of the screen. The give is to Sherman. Sherman cuts it back and is dragged down at the 1-yard line. A gain of 4 on the play. Nigel Muhammad, Isaiah Campbell there for Lehigh. 2nd down and goal for the Leopards. Lafayette has reached the red zone 32 times coming into today, scoring 84% of the time with 19 touchdowns and 8 field goals. Opponents have scored 88% of the time inside the red zone against Lehigh. 2 tight ends set for the Leopards. Nobody split out here. Fumble on the snap. It is free, picked up by Sherman, trying to race to the end zone, and he'll get in for the touchdown.
Unbelievable. Lehigh penetrates up the middle. The freshman quarterback loses the snap, but the bounce goes Lafayette way as Sherman gets a great bounce, picks it up, heads to the corner. Right there, you see the ball's on the ground. Somebody kicks it even to the outside. There's nobody out there because of how tight the Lafayette offensive formation was. Touchdown, Leopards.
So the 2nd straight year, Lafayette jumps all over Lehigh. Last year it was an interception on the 2nd play of the game, followed quickly by a touchdown. And today it's a big kickoff return that sets the stage. Ryan Graylish on for the point after. He's 30 for 32. Blake Sirfoss is the holder. The kick is good, and less than 90 seconds into the game, Lafayette has grabbed a 7-0 lead over Lehigh.
All right, let's look at that touchdown again. You see how the pulling guard, Reed does not get the, he does not get the snap, and the pulling guard actually kicks it out, and then it gets pushed to the outside, and just, you know, sometimes the ball goes your way and you need those lucky bounces, and Drew Reed got away with one. It could have been like a big turn of event.
Well, Sherman finished it with a great play, but he is the one who set it up as well with that 58-yard kickoff return to start the game.
You know, it was a short kick by Lehigh right away, and their coverage team didn't do a good job of conversion. Good blocking by the Leopards, and Sherman, you know, he's not the fastest guy out there. He's just a solid football player. He's their best football player, him and Mark Ross. So put him on kick return,
do what you got to do, and he goes in on the touchdown.
Mike, for whatever reason, Lehigh has struggled mightily out of the gate for most of the season. They've been outscored in the first quarter now, 81-44. Andy Cohen was hoping for a quick start, create some turnovers early in the game today, but he said, we've been resilient. If we fall down early, we're not going to panic. Well, that'll be the test right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Same thing happened last week as Colgate went down the first drive and scored and took an early lead on Lehigh. But what we haven't seen is a big special team play to start the game since their loss at Bucknell, when Lehigh actually fumbled the ball on the kick return, and then it was all Bucknell from there. So right now, Andy Cohen's just got to calm his team down, get them back in, get some solid offense going here.
It is the 149th meeting between these two teams. Lehigh has had the better of it lately, but Lafayette still leads overall 76-67 with five ties. Five consecutive wins for Lehigh in the series, and the Mountain Hawks are 9-3 here at Goodman Stadium. After that slow start last year, Lehigh closed with 28 straight points to win at Fisher Field 38-21. Graylish will kick off for Lafayette. Leopards moving from right to left here in the first quarter. Back deep for Lehigh is Brandon Leakes, a freshman from Simpsonsville, South Carolina, averaging 22 yards a kickoff return. So nothing new for the Mountain Hawks. You have to try and come from behind to be victorious. They have done that in six of their eight wins so far this year. Lehigh has not lost here at Goodman Stadium, but down a minute 27 into the game today. There is a bit of a breeze here, and most times it's been blowing across Goodman Stadium from the near side to the far side.
Yeah, it's gusty too. There'll be times you're down there, oh, there's no wind, and then it'll pick up. So could be a factor in the kicking game, maybe some deep passes, but other than that, it shouldn't be too much of a factor.
All in all, a great day here. Mostly sunny skies, temperature in the 40s. As Graylish puts it in the air for Lafayette. Leakes back to his 4-yard line. To the outside. Leakes will be pinned in and brought down at the 29-yard line. A return of 25. And Lehigh will put it in play offensively for the first time. There was a lot of talk around here as to who would get the start today at quarterback. Brandon Bielkowski was off to a great start to the season, suffered an injury in the Bucknell game. Both Matt McHale and Nick Shefnisky have played in the last couple of games, but it's McHale who gets the call today. Matt McHale from Madison, New Jersey. He is a 6'3", 220-pound junior, 15 for 29 on the year for 133 yards, one interception. He'll have Keith Sherman to his right on first and 10 from the 28-yard line. McHale on the read option will keep and get it across the 30 to the 32-yard line, a pickup of 4 at second down and 6. For Lehigh, Ned Daryush and A.J. Hood are the tackles, Therese Owens and Shane Rugg the starting guards, senior Matt Lippincott, the local product, is the center. Tyler Coyle will be the tight end. Lee Kerf is having a great year. One of the wide receivers, along with Josh Paris, Keith Sherman, and Zach Hayden, will be in the backfield for the Mountain Hawks. Second and 6 at their own 32-yard line. First carry for Sherman, who's had a lot of good efforts against Lafayette. Not much here. He picks up a yard, maybe two. It'll be third down for Lehigh. This Lafayette defense, very good. Second in the Patriot League, McTy and Kasha are the defensive ends. Glover and Mercado are the tackles. Tyler Robinson, the outstanding Mike Bowles, and Ben Aloy are the linebackers. Good secondary, Smalley and Davis, who had two picks last week, are the corners. Draylen James and Jared Roberts, a junior with 7 career interceptions, are the safeties. Third and 5 for the Mountain Hawks, just shy of their own 34-yard line. McHale to throw for the first time. Good protection. Nobody open as now he's flushed out of the pocket. Floats it downfield, incomplete, intended for Tyler Coyle, his tight end. And the Lafayette defense forces a 3-and-out.
More of a coverage pressure there by forcing McHale out of the pocket. He was looking on a 3-step drop. As you can see, he's looking for his man, and then nobody was open, so he's flushed out to the right side. Would have been a pretty good catch by the tight end coming across the middle. Lehigh goes 3-and-out.
Tim Divers on to punt. He's a senior from Wayne, New Jersey, averaging 40.5 yards per kick. Tim Vangelis, a freshman punt returner, 6 yards a pop. High spiral, good kick. Vangelis with a fair catch back at his 17-yard line. A good punt by Dibbers, but a great start for Lafayette. 12-1 to play first quarter. The Leopards lead Lehigh 7-0. About 16,000 will eventually work their way into Goodman Stadium. And Mikey mentioned me before kickoff, it's like a Dodger game today. Late arriving crowd here in Bethlehem. They are still filing into Goodman.
A little too much tailgating going on right now. Getting a little late, but they missed some spark by the white team across the ways. Lafayette takes an early lead. Lehigh three and out. Lafayette ball.
49-yard punt puts Lafayette back in possession, first and 10 at its own 17-yard line. The freshman Reed dropping back, trying to set up a screen, now looking to scramble as Lobb put the pressure on, and Reed will be forced out of bounds right near the line of scrimmage by Isaiah Campbell.
And on that play, as Reed drops back and looking for the screen, and he starts to scramble, he can't throw it down the field because he's all the linemen are downfield. And let's take a look at that offensive line.
Very experienced. Terlanzio and Mazur are the tackles. Borman and Angola are the guards. Angola's been playing through injury. Pat Crosby is the center. Got to watch Ross as a wide receiver. We've already seen Hall, the big tight end. Mike Duncan is the other wide receiver with Sherman and Crehan when they go to a fullback in there for the Leopards. Empty backfield here on second down and 10 from the 17-yard line. They'll run the sweep with Sherman coming off that right side, and again, he is able to elude tacklers and is out to the 34-yard line. A pickup of 17. It has been a big start to the game for Ross Sherman.
A lot of patience there. A lot of patience for Ross Sherman. Look how he does. He waits for his blocks, and he cuts in, cuts out. Real patient, finds the hole, accelerates first down.
Well, Frank Tavani said Sherman is a guy who has really come into his own this year. Great speed, but he's learned to run inside as well. Picks up a lot of yards after contact. First and 10 for the Leopards at their own 34-yard line. Three receivers set. Reed looking around, scrambling, throwing on the run, and a juggling catch incomplete, intended for Justin Adams on the sideline. Adams has been out with an injury most of the year, and he could not hang on at second down and 10.
A lot of protection there for the young freshman quarterback. Right there. Yeah, 2 feet both land out of bounds, but a great catch.
Second down and 10 for Drew Reed, who only played 6 games as a senior in high school last year. He suffered a broken collarbone. Puts ball in motion. The give left side for Sherman. Sherman will be stacked up and pushed back after a gain of 5 more. Third down and 5 for the Leopards. The Lehigh defense has been much better the last couple of weeks after giving up 48 at Bucknell. Newton had a touchdown at Colgate last week. Remington and Giles up front in that 3-4. Nigel Muhammad, a senior outside linebacker. Colton Caslow and Noah Robb, youngsters inside with Isaiah Campbell, the other outside backer. In the secondary, Damian Brown and Courtney Jarvis start at the corners. Ricky Hill and leading tackler Tyler Ward are the safeties. Lafayette converts 40% of its third down opportunities. Third and 5 at its own 39-yard line. Sherman, the long running back. Reed back to pass. Great protection. There's Ross for a first down across the 45 to the 47 before being wrestled down by Matt Lobb.
Good patience by the freshman quarterback. Waits for his big wide receiver to clear across the middle. You can see a little linebacker blitz in the middle. Some stunt games with Lehigh's defense. First down. Here we can see Ross. Just goes across the middle, right? He knows he's in the open window right there. He sits. First down.
On first down, the give is to Sherman. Sherman into Lehigh territory and falling forward for a gain of 6 to the 47. Second down and 4 for the Leopards.
I know it's early in the game here, Steve, but one thing you do see from way up high here is the push by the white offensive line of the Lafayette Leopards. There's no penetration from Lehigh's front 7. And right now the running game will open up that passing game. Good balance attack here by Frank Tavani's Lafayette.
Second down and 4. Play action to Sherman. Reed over the middle for Ross. Open inside the 30, down to the 26-yard line. And Lafayette is doing everything right here in the first quarter.
And there it was. They did the same look they did on the last run. There's the play fake to Sherman. Perfect strike across the middle. Big target, great hands. There's the all-time leading receiver for Lafayette.
Lafayette at the 26-yard line, leading 7-0, looking for more. Dixon in motion on first and 10. They throw it out quickly to Dixon. Ross is the blocker. Dixon makes a move to the inside and will have another first down to the 15-yard line. A pickup of 11 more.
Offense coordinator Mickey Fine for Lafayette is doing a great job of keeping Lehigh's defense off balance. Throwing on first down, running on first down, mixing it up. It's about balance attack, 50-50 run pass. And then you throw the screen out there, but you've got this big wide receiver blocking a smaller cornerback, and Mark Ross really created that play in the red zone, Lafayette is.
Dixon wasn't targeted much in the win over Fordham last week. He makes his 25th catch of the season there for a gain of 11. On the delay to Sherman. Sherman gets stood up and picks up 3 yards to the 13-yard line. Call it a gain of 2, second down and 8.
It's the first running play Lehigh's really stopped.
Colton Caswell, freshman linebacker, in on the hit. He and Tim Newton from Lake Brantley High School in Florida. Second down and 8 for the Leopards. As we approach the midway point of the first quarter, they lead 7-0. Dixon and Adams split out to the left. Ross split to the right. Reed, play action. Now rolling right. Giles giving chase. Reed throws incomplete. Ross coming back to the ball. Was covered nicely by Damian Brown. It's third down and 8.
True Reed might have been better just taking off and using his legs. He can run pretty good. He's a really good athlete. Pike could have picked up about 5, 6, 7 yards if he would have ran. He likes to throw the ball. Lehigh's lost contain on the young quarterback, too, every time he's dropped back to pass. Gotta think Lehigh's gonna come with some type of pressure here.
Reed's been incredibly accurate. Even with 4 interceptions last week, he's completed 74% of his passes. He was put in at halftime of the Harvard game and then responded as a starter the following week at Holy Cross with an outstanding performance. Low snap gets by Reed, and he will just fall on it back at the 32-yard line, and that may take them out of field goal range as well.
Two mistakes by Lafayette in the red zone. First time they got away with it and end up getting a touchdown. Here, a ball that doesn't even get off the ground. Look, that's just bowled back from the center and probably takes them out of field goal range. If not, it's a long field goal, and you don't really want to punt from the 31-yard line, but you're looking at 4th and 25, 27.
Ryan Grelish's career-long field goal is 46 yards from here to be about a 48-yarder.
Now, they're going to leave their offense out there. Right now, you just got to watch Verizon, vertical patterns. You've got to have those safeties back. You've got to take away the vertical patterns.
4th and 26, Reed throwing into the end zone for Ross, who pushes off and makes the catch for the touchdown.
Wow.
He gets away with a push-off, no flag, and Lafayette converts a 4th and 26.
Andy Cohen is livid, and rightfully so. 16,000 people saw a two-hand shove on the defender. They ran the 4 verticals. Lafayette gets a touchdown. Here's number 10, just running down the field. He's covered, and right here, boom, shoved out of the way. Touchdown, Lafayette. And they're going up by 14 points if they get the extra point here.
8th touchdown catch of the year for Mark Ross, the 27th of his career. Grealish for the point after. It is good, and it has been a perfect start for the Lafayette Leopards, trying to snap a 5-game losing streak to their arch rival. Ross creates some space, 31-yard touchdown, 14-0 Leopards, 6:39 to play in the first. Great start for Lafayette. 2 possessions, 2 touchdowns. 14-0, the Leopards leading Lehigh, and Mark Ross, very much a concern for Andy Cohen, showing why here this afternoon, Mike.
That drive was a lot of Mark Ross on the first down pickup, on the first down play action across the middle, and then the last play was 4th down and a mile.
You can see Lehigh Ricky Hill right away looking for an offensive pass interference call.
I think the focus right here is Lehigh have not let that bother them. They've got to recover, because right now, I mean, obviously probably one of the worst non-calls that Lehigh saw all year, but they have to recover from it. They can't let it get to them. You're going to really be battling the officials as opposed to battling a team that has a lot of momentum and took a 2-score lead here with 6:39 to go in the first quarter.
A 12-play drive for the Leopards. Lehigh down 2 touchdowns.
Who do you work for that?
Grealish to kick off. Sherman is back deep along with Leakes. Winner of this game will play next weekend in the FCS playoffs by virtue of the automatic bid for winning the Patriot League Championship. End over end, Leakes at the 9-yard line this time. Leakes will bring it across the 30, and he'll be wrestled down there by Tyler Robinson. Being down, not necessarily strange territory for Lehigh. They've been down in a lot of games the last couple of years, including a 20-point fourth quarter deficit in the season opener this year against Central Connecticut State, and they were down by 11 at Lafayette last year.
Absolutely, they've been there before, but what they did is always somehow recover with something to create the momentum back, and they don't want to fall down too far with the energy that Lafayette's playing with. They've got to try to move the sticks here, get some momentum back, and then get some type of points on this drive.
Lafayette coming off its first win over a top five team after beating Fordham last week. It is carried over to today. Sherman shakes off a tackle and he'll be dragged down shy of the 35-yard line. A pickup of 2, second down and 8.
Probably if you talk to Frank Tavani or Andy Cohen after the game, everything that could go right, Frank Tavani, I could never imagine it would be that perfect of a start. Andy Cohen can't think of a worse start, from his special team play to offense 3 and out, defense giving up some first downs, and then the big play on 4th and a mile.
Three receivers to the left for McHale. Sherman will go in motion. Five receiver set. McHale will keep it and get nothing.
Yeah, it's got to be able to throw the football. They've only thrown the ball one time here in 5 offensive plays. And right there, they empty the backfield. 2nd and 7. Run the quarterback draw. Lafayette sniffed it out. Now in a 3rd and long situation for McHale.
Lafayette coming in, allowing just 206 yards a game through the air. Lehigh throws for 309 a contest. Sherman on a wing right this time. 2 receivers each way. Kerfus in motion. McHale rolling. Looking. Nothing. Short of the first down is Mike Bowles, the leading tackler, steps up and makes the play at the 38-yard line. It's 4th down and 3.
Coverage again. Good coverage by Lafayette. Matt McHale rolls to his right. Nobody's open downfield. He takes off again. Too much to get.
Jared Roberts is back to receive this time. Tim Divers, a 49-yard punt in his first attempt. 4.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. It has been all Lafayette. Bowles, another nice spiral. Roberts at the 12-yard line will get tripped up as he brings it across the 15. Nice tackle by Courtney Jarvis.
Exact same spot, maybe a yard difference, where Lafayette started their last drive.
50-yard kick by Divers. Lafayette will have it 1st and 10 at the 16-yard line.
Give credit to the Leopard offense too. They're making plays. Did a great job staying on their blocks, and that young man, Drew Reed, has been on fire.
Sherman will step to his right. 2 receivers split out that way. Sherman on 1st down weaves his way across the 20. Nigel Muhammad and Ricky Hill will make the stop after a gain of 6 to the 22. It's 2nd and 4.
Little counterplay by the Lafayette offense. Sherman being patient, staying behind his blocker. Has some nice size to him. 202 pounds, 6'1" tailback.
Receiver each way for Reed this time.
A
play action to Sherman over the middle, again to his tight end Hall, wide open out near the 40-yard line. Tyler Ward will make the stop, but that's an easy pitch and catch for 17 yards.
Lafayette's obviously seen something with the linebackers biting up. That is the third or fourth time they played action, hit somebody real quick across the middle. Whether it's the tight end or whether it's the receiver, Martin Ross, that has been their spot on the field that's been really successful early going.
Reed is 6 for 8 for 115 yards and a touchdown. Throwing on first down, and he will be put down. Colton Caslow, the freshman, with his second sack of the season, and Lehigh finally gets a big play, a loss of 8.
The first play Lehigh has made on defense. The only time they've stopped Lafayette's offense was a mistake by Lafayette, and there the freshman linebacker out of Florida comes bursting through, puts him in a 2nd and 19.
Caslow, freshman, the Mountain Hawks are very high on. Three receivers set for the Leopards. Reed on 2nd down and 18. Under pressure again. Escapes and has a lot of room. Flag is thrown. This one will probably come back for holding as Reed has a first down. Still on his feet. And will go down at the Lehigh 43-yard line. But the umpire, Robert Kinter, threw a flag. There's our referee, Tony Marcella.
Oh, 62 on the offense. 10 yards from the original line of scrimmage. Second down.
And Tavandy not happy at all, but again, he saw the flag come out before the scramble by Drew Reed. Let's look to our right side. 62, the right guard,
yeah,
Max Angola.
See the jersey go and look at it. Rob Kinner's looking right at it.
So instead of a 26-yard scramble for a first down, the ball is back to the 21-yard line. Lehigh has to take advantage of a penalty and a good defensive stop by Caslow.
2nd down and 28. Empty backfield for Reed. Ross Sherman is split out to the right. They ran him on a jet sweep off of motion earlier, and they'll do the same thing here. Nigel Muhammad shakes off the block, gets help from Newton and Jarvis at the 26-yard line, a gain of 5. It's 3rd and 23. You mentioned Tony Marcella is the referee, Robert Kinter the umpire. The head linesman is Mike Stevens. The side judge is Tim Gallagher. The back judge is Ronald Roberts Jr. And Mike, the line judge, John Miley, and the field judge, Vince Bacanfuso, both refereeing their final games today. They're retiring after nearly 30 years of service each. Part of this officiating crew here this afternoon.
Lehigh's got to keep everything in front of them. No penalties here. You want to get the ball back, whether it's by a punt or a turnover.
3rd and 23 for Reed. Lehigh rushing just 3. Reed to run, and he'll be brought down by Nigel Muhammad at the 29-yard line as they had a spy on Reed that time. And Lafayette will have to punt for the first time today.
1 minute to go in the first quarter, and the first positive thing that Lehigh has done, forcing a punting situation by Lafayette. There's Nigel Muhammad, senior captain, making the play.
Josh Parrish to return. Ryan Forrester, a freshman punter, 35 and a half yards a kick. Into a bit of a breeze, handles a high snap. Lehigh blocks it to Sean Mitchell with the block. Mountain Hawks will recover, and Rigo will take it down to the 10-yard line.
The best sound in football, Steve Degler, double thud. And right there you see Lehigh coming with pressure. We'll get a couple looks at it. It's coming up the middle. I believe it's at number 59 on the block to Sean Mitchell. Gets his hand on the punt.
Oliver Rigo, I believe, on the recovery. It's either Rigo or Campbell.
Yeah, there it was. It was Mitchell with the block.
And it is Rigo with the recovery. And he takes it to the 10-yard line. That is the 4th kick Lafayette has had blocked this year. It's the 4th block for Lehigh.
Matt McHale stays in at quarterback. We're expecting a rotation coming after the 3rd or 4th series. This is the 3rd series.
Sherman around the outside to the pylon, flag is down. Sherman in for the touchdown, but a penalty flag is down.
It's going to be Holder on Lehigh.
Holder, number 80 on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
And you got Lee Curtis.
Still first down.
Andy Cohen upset because, you know, he's saying, well, what about the touchdown they had? Where was the hold? But again, they called it on 80. We don't know if it is on 80, but again, that flag did come out before Sherman busted down the sideline. Well, let's look. They called it on 80. Let's see what Purvis is doing out there. Now, it came back at the line of scrimmage. It wasn't on him. Yeah, that's back at the end of the line, maybe on one of the tackles or the tight end.
So it's 10 yards from the spot, the ball back to the 18-yard line. It is first and goal there for the Mountain Hawks. Sergio Fernandez Soto, Josh Parris split out to the right. Purvis has single coverage out to the left. McHale looking short, throws to Parris. Smalley hits him immediately at the 14-yard line, a gain of 4, it's second and goal.
Although Lehigh wants to get 6 here, they've got to be patient. You don't want to make a mistake and take away the opportunity for a field goal.
Well, Lehigh hit early by Lafayette. The Leopards score 2 quick touchdowns. And after one quarter here in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, in the battle for the Patriot League Championship, it is Lafayette leading Lehigh 14-0. Steve Degler, Mike Yadish, Troy Hine back at Goodman Stadium in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Start of the second quarter in what is the Patriot League Championship game. NCAA berth on the line. Lafayette leads 14-0. Lehigh has a second and goal at the 14. McHale, play action, rolling right, looking left, will keep, trying to scramble to the outside, and will be brought down at the 10-yard line by Draylen James. That's a long run for a gain of 4, it's third and goal.
Well, Matt McHale was in the same situation that Drew Reed was in for Lafayette earlier. The screen wasn't open, they sniffed it out, they covered Sherman. So as he's starting to scramble, he cannot throw the ball downfield because his linemen are downfield. So he's got to run and do everything he can to get as much yards as possible.
Third and goal at the 10. Parris and Purvis will go out to the right. Zach Hayden, the fullback, on a wing left.
They like fades to Curtis, but they're playing off him to the top of your screen.
McHale over the middle, in traffic, touchdown! Tight end Tyler Coyle gets Lehigh on the board.
What a great job by Matt McHale. The coaches said he had a good week of practice. He sat back, he looked left, his man wasn't open. Then right across the middle, look where he puts that ball, between the linebacker, between the defender. Touchdown, Tyler Coyle. Look at that. What a great placement, great catch by the big tight end.
19th catch of the year for Coyle, his second for a touchdown. And that is the first touchdown pass thrown by Matt McHale. Handy with the extra point. It is good, and 53 seconds into the second quarter, Lehigh has cut that deficit in half. It's 14-7 Lafayette.
You got to give the special teams credit. RJ Ryan, the special team coach for Lehigh, dialing up a punt block as Lehigh's number 59 came free to Sean Mitchell. Watch Sean Mitchell right in the middle. He's not blocked, comes free, runs through the punt. Lehigh recovers. They overcome a holding penalty on a touchdown called back. And they get in the score on this touchdown pass to Tyler Coyle from Matt McHale.
So Lehigh trying to stabilize things a little bit right now. It has been McHale the whole way. We have not seen Nick Shafnisky as of yet, the freshman from Whitehall here in the Lehigh Valley. 3 plays, 10 yards after that block punt.
And Matt McHale hasn't thrown the ball much. Most of the time he's dropped back, he's been forced to run. I think he's only released 2 passes from his hand, maybe 3.
Handy will kick off. Smalley is back deep. So is Ross Sherman, who returned the opening kickoff, 52 yards.
Yeah, his coverage has been good all year until that first kickoff of the game.
Andy will line this one left. Yes,
he can't do that. Out of bounds. He did that last week. He kicked 2 out of bounds up at up at Colgate. That gives the Leopards the ball at the 35-yard line.
It's his fourth kick out of bounds on the season. All right, fans, you can get involved in the rivalry, too, by taking part in today's Lehigh-Lafayette Alumni Giving Challenge. Text the word Lehigh or Pard and your name to the number 20222 to make a $10 gift to your school. Gifts must be made before the opening kickoff of the third quarter. Every point counts, so text early and often. And don't let that other school win. Step up to the challenge and stay tuned as the winning school will be announced during the fourth quarter.
Now I understand Pandy's kicking it into the breeze. It's kind of angling, as you said, across the field, but into his face a little bit there. But you got to cover those. Three kickoffs out of bounds in the last 2 weeks.
First and 10 for Lafayette at its own 35-yard line. Drew Reed with Sherman next to him. Play action, swings it out for Adams. Adams brought down across the 40 by Isaiah Campbell and Ricky Hill. They run that screen with Ross as the lead blocker. A gain of 7 to the 42 at second and 3.
The same play they ran to the Lafayette sideline in the 2 series ago with Mark Ross out blocking. Throw it out to Justin Adams. Nice pickup.
Sherman on a second down and 3. Matt Lobb gets a hold of him after a gain of a yard. It's third down and 2. We'll take a look at some out-of-town action. Holy Cross leading Georgetown in the first quarter. Fordham, which lost last week, leads Colgate 7-0. Fordham eligible for the Patriot League title starting next year. Swimming and diving last night on the men's side, Lehigh beating Lafayette. And on the women's side, the Mountain Hawks get the sweep over the Leopards. Third down and 2 for Lafayette. The give is to Sherman, flea flicker. Adams is open down the field, and he makes the catch in stride. It will be dragged down by Damian Brown at the 7-yard line.
What a gutsy call by Frank Tavani's staff. Third and short, they go to flea flicker. Justin Adams gets behind the secondary, and Drew Reed puts the ball right out in front of him to catch it in stride. Lafayette knocking on the door.
Gain of 49 yards on the flea flicker. First and goal at the 8 is where they mark it. Sherman bouncing to the outside. Damian Brown will nudge him out of bounds. Just inside the 5 at the 4, it's second down and goal.
Lafayette overcomes the momentum shift by Lehigh with a great drive of themselves, started by the kickoff out of bounds.
Good point, all started with that. And this freshman, very, very poised. Frank Tavani knew he would be. He said this guy does not get too excited one way or the other. Four interceptions last week did not bother him one bit. He throws for Ross, and it's incomplete. Third and goal at the 4.
Mark Ross looked like he got a little tangled up there in his footing. Drew Reed threw it to his outside shoulder where only he could catch it.
Here's what Frank Tavani told me about Drew Reed. He said he's a very cool young man. He doesn't get too excited either way. He learns from everything, and he's played in big games in high school and the 6A classification in Tennessee in front of big crowds. He said he told me, this is Coach Tavani talking, he told me, Coach, I don't get nervous.
You got to watch Sherman to the left of Reed right now, swinging out of the backfield. They got 3 receivers down here.
Third and goal at the 4. Lehigh brings pressure. Adams is wide open and walks in for the touchdown. His first of the season.
Wide open. They did swing Sherman out to the left of Reed. Nobody picked up number 4. It must have been a coverage breakdown for Lehigh. And Lafayette answers. You see, he's just running like that little bubble screen. And if Lehigh was in man coverage, nobody went with number 4. If Lehigh was in zone, somebody left their zone out here in the flat.
Grealish to restore a 2-touchdown lead. Lafayette answers right back with its 3rd touchdown of the day. 12:22 to play in the first half. The Leopards leading Lehigh 21-7. Lafayette answering right back, leading 21-7 early in the second quarter. And another very impressive drive engineered by freshman quarterback Drew Reed, finding Justin Adams a couple of times.
Yeah, Justin Adams is having a pretty good first half, along with Mark Ross. And not the easiest catch in the world on that flea flicker either. It was out on his fingertips, and Then he just waltzes into the end zone. I think he was surprised right there. Shouldn't there be somebody on me?
Adams had 12 catches, or rather four catches last year. He is over 20 now on this season as he caps a six-play, 65-yard drive with a four-yard touchdown catch. Keith Sherman back deep for Lehigh, along with Brandon Leakes, as Graylish will kick off for Lafayette. Leopards moving from left to right here in quarter number two, leading by two touchdowns. Big hit delivered on special teams, nearly forcing a turnover.
I don't know where Leakes is going. He's running right into the defender. He's got to see that guy and try to make this one guy miss. And hat on the ball.
Alex Merriman with the hit.
Merriman put his hat on the ball, and now Lehigh backed up inside their 20.
The Mountain Hawks really having a tough time here in the first half. First and 10 at the 17. Nick Shafniski was warming on the sideline, and the freshman will get his first series under center. Shafniski, 6'1", 200 pounds. He has completed 22 of 35 passes, two interceptions, four touchdowns, 270 yards. He's also run for 109 yards and a touchdown. He has been named the Patriot League Rookie of the Week each of the last 2 weeks. Empty backfield on first down. Shafniski throws the screen and nearly throws it right to Lafayette's Darren Wright, who was right there and could not make the catch.
Kerfus goes right to Nick Shafniski. The screen was set up for Kerfus coming across the middle. Shafniski had pressure so fast, he just threw the ball into the line with no Lehigh eligible receiver near the ball.
Shafniski from Whitehall, Pennsylvania, right here in the Valley. He was the Lehigh Valley Conference Co-Player of the Year as a senior. Rushing for more than 1,000 yards, throwing for better than 1,000 yards as well.
Laycock down under 10. Haven't gotten Sherman going on the ground yet either.
Just get the snap off. Quarterback draw for Shafniski. And he will not escape Ben Alloy for a loss on the play back to the 15-yard line. And I don't think Lafayette can play any better. It has been a near-perfect first half for the Leopards.
Now, if it wasn't for that block punt, you'd probably have a 21-0 lead right now. Lee Curtis has got to touch the ball. They tried on the screen there. This is where he's always been good, across the middle on a dig route. John Luce, the defensive coordinator for Lafayette, loves to blitz from different angles. And right now, I guarantee you, they're going to put pressure on the young freshman in a third and 11, backed up on their own 16-yard line.
No doubt, trips to the left. Twist inside, Shafniski rolling, squares the shoulders, throws for Kerfus, well short. Lehigh will have to punt.
Very difficult pass to make. Rolling to his left, turning all the way across his body as a right-handed quarterback. Kerfus was open, as you can see. Here goes Shafniski, all the way across, couldn't get enough arm strength on that pass.
For some reason, the clock is still running here at Goodman Stadium after an incomplete pass. I think the officials finally noticed it. It's still running.
Stop button must be stuck.
The incomplete pass came with about 11 and a half minutes remaining.
Please reset the game clock to 11:35.
Good job,
11:35. Thank you.
Andy Cohen on the left, his team reeling right now. Frank Tavani, not comfortable. They led at halftime last year, and he said, we just did not come out and play in the second half. Dimmers with a low line drive away from Vangelis, and it takes another good roll. Dimmers has been a big hero for Lehigh here in the first half. A 47-yard punt, first and 10 at the 31-yard line. A special welcome to all the fans watching today's game on the Patriot League Network. Our next Lehigh broadcast comes your way on Sunday, December 1st, when the men's basketball team hosts Sacred Heart at 2 p.m. For more information on the Patriot League Network, visit patriotleague.tv.
With 11:26 to go in the half. You don't want to say it was a must stop by Lehigh's defense, but they've got to find a way to get Lafayette off the field. They've only forced them to punt one time.
Reed is 9-for-12 for 175 yards, two touchdowns. He'll throw again on first down as he's flushed out of there and will scramble to the 35-yard line for a pickup of four, chased out by Tim Newton.
His legs have been pretty good too. Saw that holding call that got called back the time they were forced to punt. He did a great job of scrambling and so kept his eyes downfield. Young man from Tennessee's having a good first half.
Lead a game in high school, Mike. Six touchdowns in a playoff game. He was 20-for-20, 286 yards. Incredibly accurate. Second down and six for the freshman. Sherman on the counter. Patiently waiting, has another first down. Across the 40 to the 44-yard line, a pickup of nine.
You said it best, Steve. He's just patient. Doing a really good job of letting his blockers get out in front of him, picking up the hole. Here you can see guard pulled a tight end from the backside. And look at the block. The 6'7" tight end gets on a Lehigh linebacker.
First and 10 for the Leopards at their own 44-yard line. Demetrius Dixon with a flag on the play at the 31-yard line.
Well, that's going to be defensive pass interference. They're just making plays right now, Lafayette is.
Well, Lehigh thinks it's going the other way. Our referee, Tony Marcella, will explain.
I would be surprised. Because it didn't look like the Lehigh defender was turned, but Lafayette's walking backwards. Maybe it's a makeup call. From
pass interference. Offense. Number 88. 15 yards from the original line of scrimmage.
Now let's take a look at it. Here you can see number 88, Demetrius Dixon. I don't know about that. You know, I would call that on the defender. I mean, they're both hand fighting, and the Lafayette receiver was facing the ball. Lehigh's defender was not facing the ball.
All I'm going to say in this is if you don't call Ross on the touchdown, you can't call that.
Correct. they're not even close.
To me, that's just let them
play. That's either a no call or defensive pass interference, but Lehigh needed some type of break.
Now first and 25, they're back really at the 29-yard line.
Really playing loose in the secondary right now. Let's run their throw-out screen.
Reed over the middle. Ross wide open again. Has a lot of the yardage back as he's out near midfield. And second and four after a first and 25.
Lehigh's got to do something to defend the play action over the middle passes. That is the fourth one of the day. The tight end or Ross, look at that, he's just in space. Noah Robb in coverage.
That'll put Mark Ross over 1,000 yards receiving on the season, and look at the total yards, all Lafayette. Lehigh's defense has to dig in here and get a stop. Second and four at midfield.
He's got to be careful on the side of offside down here on the wide receiver.
Caswell with the pressure, looking for a second sack. That Reed throws it away.
Is he in the pocket?
There's no receiver in the area.
That should be intentional grounding. He's in the pocket. He's not outside the tackle box because that ball was on the hash mark, and he threw that ball from the hash mark.
And there's the flag.
See, he's on the hash mark, and now he's still inside that area, still on the hash mark, intentional grounding.
Number seven on the offense. Loss of down. Third down.
Frank Tavanis has to be pulled off the field by one of his assistants over there. He is livid right now, but he is completely wrong in his argument because he was in the pocket and did throw the ball away.
And there was no receiver anywhere near that pass. So the ball marked at the 29-yard line. It's a loss of down. So it's third and 20.
Watch the Verizon again, the vertical patterns. Mark Ross to the top. He has got to contain the quarterback, so he doesn't buy time either.
He handles a low snap. Goes for Dixon and Tyler Ward. The leading tackler will hit him immediately at the 42-yard line. A gain of eight, Lafayette will have to punt.
Tyler Ward's having a great year. As you said, Steve, the leading tackler, co-captain. senior safety.
Guy who was told his entire career he was too small to play. Senior out of Charlottesville, Virginia, came in with 89 tackles on the season. In fact, when he signed up to play as a youngster, he put weights under his pads, Mike, so he'd make weight.
Nice.
Forrester to punt. Harris back to return.
Harris is not very deep right now.
Wobbly spiral. Harris back to his 15. Across the 20 to the 22-yard line, where he is brought down by Colton Kirkpatrick. We've got a timeout at Goodman Stadium. Lehigh gets a stop. Can the offense get it going? Trailing 21-7 with 8.5 left in the first half. Back at Goodman Stadium in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Lafayette holding a 21-7 lead on Lehigh with 8 minutes and 31 seconds to play in the first half. Lehigh will take over. First and 10 at its own 22. Looks like Matt McHale will be back. And Mike, you were saying in the break, in order to get the ball to Lee Kerfus, who has 92 catches on the year, you've got to establish a running game to open things up. Keith Sherman has carried twice for 4 yards today.
Yeah, I think Keith Sherman's got to carry the ball. I think Dave Chiquini, the offensive coordinator, knows that. He can't panic right now. Down 14 with 8:31 to go in the first half. They've got to give number 20 the ball. They got to go forward. He has the ability to break some tackles. I wouldn't be surprised you see him carry the ball a couple times on this possession.
And he's had the uncanny knack of coming up with big plays against Lafayette the last couple of years. He is to the left of McHale. Sherman will get the carry on first down off the right side. Not much, maybe 3 to the 25. Keith Sherman trying to become the first Mountain Hawk to rush for 1,000 yards in a season since Jermaine Pugh in 2002. Sherman with his 7 yards today sits at 930.
Lehigh's going to go fast. First time they're going hurry up on the day.
Second down and 7. Sherman gets his second straight carry, bursts this one into the secondary, and he'll have a first down across the 35 to the 37-yard line, a gain of 12.
Continue to hurry up fast. That's been their staple run, that little fullback tray where he follows the pulling guard. Watch right now. You can see there comes. It's actually, they moved the tight end, too, doing the same thing Lafayette did. It was the tight end was coming around the counter tray along with the guard.
They opted then to huddle as they changed some personnel. They looked like they were going to go hurry up. First down for the Mountain Hawks. Here is Sherman again, sweeping left side, tries to cut it back across the 45 out near midfield, where Jared Roberts will push him out of bounds after a gain of 12 more. First and 10 at the Lehigh 49.
Changes your whole offense. You can get the running game going. Now your play action will work. Because think about how much Lehigh's defense has struggled with the play action of Lafayette. They were able to run the ball. The play action's been there all day.
Sherman out, Sean Farrell will come in at tailback.
If you can't get the running game going, you don't have that.
Harris and Kerfus split out to the right. Tight end and wing left for the Mountain Hawks. And first and 10 at their own 49. McHale, three-man rush, nobody open. Will scramble and will get into Lafayette territory at the 44-yard line. A pickup of 7 at second down and 3. Mike, we have a chance to talk to Marty Horn, former Lehigh quarterback, Hall of Famer, two-time MVP of this game. He is not only doing the radio broadcast for Lehigh today, but he was Matt McHale's coach in high school in Madison, New Jersey. Couldn't say enough good things about the young man.
Yeah, he said McHale was a gamer and did some great things for them, and he likes his legs. Right there, what we saw with him, his legs.
Second and 3 for McHale. Farrell stays in at running back. He will get his first carry. Now it's McHale, pardon me, as McHale keeps. And he'll have a first down inside the 40. Well-executed read option. First down at the 38-yard line.
It's the only way you can get that play to work is if the quarterback carries out his fake and pulls the ball. He's reading the last guy in the line of scrimmage. And the last guy in the line of scrimmage comes down.
Hello, this is Jimmy Johnson from the Patriot League Network. The internet feed from this game dropped for a short period. During that time, Lehigh's Matt McHale found Lee Kerfus for a 9-yard touchdown to cut Lafayette's lead to 21-14. We now return to live action on the ensuing kickoff.
He has got to cover this kickoff. You know, changes the whole attitude of Lafayette. If Lafayette gets good field position, they might put their pedal, put the foot on the gas. If Lehigh pins Lafayette back, they might be, let's just run the ball and get to halftime.
Handy to kick off. Smalley was one of the return men for Lafayette, so he is not available. It's Vangelis and Sherman. Sherman at the 7-yard line. across the 30, shy of the 35 with 1:03 left in the half. This is the seventh time that Lehigh and Lafayette are meeting with the Patriot League Championship at stake. The classic one, 1995, Brian Klingerman's catch in overtime in a 37-30 win. And we showed you the Lafayette one where they rolled over Lehigh in the second half in 2006.
Well, that 1995 game, that's why we're playing at 12:30 now. it was in the dark. It was starting to get dark here. And they're like, wait, we got no lights. So they started moving all the games up to 12:30. After the clocks changed, now Lehigh just starts all games at 12:30.
So Lafayette has won four of those six championship meetings, including the last three. Reed will throw it out to Dixon. And Dixon will scamper out of bounds after a short game to the 37, a pickup of three. Second down and seven. And we should note, Mike, that 50 years ago to the day this game was to be played, and it was postponed a week because of the assassination of President Kennedy in Dallas, Texas, which happened 50 years ago yesterday.
I remember I read that years ago, and then obviously the news, the sports page, the local sports page mentioned it again. The NFL continued, but a lot of college football, including the rivalry between Lehigh Lafayette, got moved back a week.
The 1963 game was moved from November 23rd to November 30th. Looking, scrambling, and will get across the 40 to the 43, yards shy of a first down.
I'm surprised Lafayette does not take a timeout right now. Very surprised they don't take a timeout.
It's a third and a long one. 37 seconds left in the half. Three-man rush. Reed throws short to Hall, who'll make the catch and just inches way across midfield. The clock will stop to move the chains with just under 31 seconds left, and Hall is down after a hard hit.
Lafayette will take a timeout here even before Hall went down. I think they called timeout.
They did take their second timeout of the half. But now they put themselves in a position where they can start taking shots downfield. And you notice there in Frank Tavani's jacket, a blue and maroon sticker with the initials AB. Explain that in a moment.
Oh, look like he got kind of bent backwards there in the tackle.
Lafayette players and the coaching staff wearing those blue and maroon stickers with the initials AB, and this brings the human side of this game into focus. Aubrey Bombach is a Lafayette first year student majoring in engineering. She's a member of the crew and soccer clubs. She was the victim of a hit-and-run accident on November 8th, ironically on Lehigh Avenue is where it took place. Near the city, near the crew club's boathouse in Easton, she remains hospitalized. The stickers with the AB are in her honor. The game was dedicated to her last week. Her family was presented with a game ball. Coach Frank Tavani told me on Thursday that Aubrey's still in a coma at St. Luke's Hospital. She's undergone several surgeries, so certainly she's become a focal point for this Lafayette team. And there was an announcement made here at Goodman Stadium before the game asking everyone on both sides to join in support of Aubrey's recovery. We wish the same as well.
I have to know where number 10 is.
First and 10 at the Lehigh 49-yard line. Reed rolling right, throwing incomplete for the backup tight end, Morgan Donahue, a senior from Madison, Connecticut. Second down and 10 with 24 seconds left in the half. Again, Lehigh deferred its choice in the first half after winning the coin toss, and the Mountain Hawks will get the football in the third quarter, hoping it'll give them a chance to tie the game.
Yeah, I'm almost shocked. If they're able to contain Lafayette here and go in 21-14, almost shocked with, you know, when we see the statistics that'll be popped up on your screen at halftime. They'll be highly in favor of Lafayette.
Both Lehigh scoring drives have been short, 10 yards and 32 yards. With a block punt and a penalty. And there is Donahue, the intended receiver again. Well defended, Tyler Ward, the safety, got there just in time.
What Lafayette tried to do is they cleared everybody to the outside. And just a little delay there with the tight end over the middle. Tyler Ward, a great play. You can even see Sherman coming out of the backfield. Job Ward not hooking that left arm around them, making the play. You're taking a chance there because if you miss that play, that could be six.
Third and 10 at the Lehigh 49. Again, Graylish's longest field goal in his career, 46 yards.
They would pick up 20 yards. Lafayette takes a shot. You know, Lehigh's thinking they'll stop him, make him punt. Three-man rush. Great for Ross. Ross will scamper out of bounds and get the first down. Inside the 40 at the 38-yard line. He picked up 11 with 14 seconds left in the half.
And a design play. They just delayed Ross. Delayed him, cleared everybody else out, and then brought him short across the middle and just let him use his legs for the first down.
They're going into a bit of a breeze right now.
They got one more play. I think they got one more play. Your typical play is 6 seconds, Steve. So,
and the whole field's open because they have a timeout.
Absolutely.
So, again, they need to get 10, 12 yards to get in range for Graylish. Don't want to give up a sack if you're Jordan Reed. Reed throwing a deep out for Adams, and he will make the catch inside the 20 at the 17-yard line. A pickup of 21 with 7 seconds left in the half.
Well, I said, as you see the completion on a great passing catch by Adams, 6 seconds, your typical play. Well, they got 7.2. But Frank Tavani's telling them right now, listen, you get rid of this ball here. We'll take a shot. You be smart. You get rid of it. We'll bring out the field goal team if we have to. Lehigh's got to defend that end zone here.
Well, this freshman has been everything as advertised. Very calm back
I would
there.
Still watch 29 out of that backfield. Lehigh had a coverage breakdown the last touchdown down in this end zone.
Lehigh bringing some pressure. They throw it over the top to Ross, and it's incomplete with Courtney Jarvis on coverage with 3.7 seconds left in the half.
Feet got tangled up there. Everybody in the stadium just concerned there could be a penalty. No call.
Field goal unit coming on. Graylish to kick.
35-yard attempt. 35-yard attempt.
He's 9 for 10 on the season. He has made 5 in a row. Blake Searfoss is the holder. Morgan Donahue is the snapper. This will be a 34-yard kick.
They've been rolling the dice all. He has got to watch a fake.
Good spot. And the kick is blocked. Second block of the half for Lehigh. Lafayette picks it up. Cannot advance that ball. And Lehigh will dodge one again. They block a punt, they block a field goal, and somehow are down just 7 points at halftime in the 149th meeting of college football's most played rivalry.
I can't tell who that is. Is that Ricky Layton?
Up the middle. Ricky Layton gets his third block of the season.
And that looked like that ball was headed right between the goalposts. Looked like a good hold, good kick. Good play by Ricky Layton.
So Lafayette came out blazing, led 14-0 with 6:39 left in the first half. Lehigh has stabilized a bit and trails by 7 here at the break. And the Mountain Hawks will get the football to begin the third quarter, trailing 21-14. What a wild first half here at Goodman Stadium. Sold out Goodman Stadium in Bethlehem, as you heard at halftime. The 150th edition of this rivalry will be in the Bronx next year, as Lehigh and Lafayette will take the show on the road to Yankee Stadium. Lehigh earlier this week put the standing room only tickets on sale for the bank, and I think that was well received the way it looks, Mike.
I think a lot of people are giving up their seat in the stand to be on the bank right now. As you see the Lehigh side full across the ways, even though it's a sellout, some people like to stand or sit on the hill, but a great atmosphere here today at Goodman Stadium.
The Lehigh did win the coin toss, deferred its choice until the second half, so the Mountain Hawks will get the ball here, down by 7 points. We'll have to check on the availability of 3 Lafayette players injured late in the first half, tight end Brandon Hall and defensive back Matt Smalley, along with defensive end Jake McTighe.
Sun comes into factors. You look down, you see how the shadows are. If you're running, you're Lehigh's offense right now, and you're a receiver running downfield, and you look back, a lot of times those low passes at this time of the day could be caught up in the sun. You got to watch that.
Ryan Graylish will kick off for the Leopards in their white uniforms, moving from left to right. Keith Sherman is back along with Courtney Jarvis. Brandon Leakes fumbled the kickoff in the first half that Sherman recovered, so Andy Cohen has made a switch there on special teams. Graylish end over end. It'll be Jarvis at the 10-yard line. Courtney Jarvis starts right now, reverses left, looking to turn that corner, and he'll slip down at the 25-yard line. They'll mark him at the 26.
First and 10 for the Mountain Hawks, who completed just 5 of 11 passes in the first half. All of the completions by Matt McHale.
Yeah, the only positive plays in the passing game were the 2 touchdowns. Other than that, Lehigh's passing game has been completely off, and I wouldn't be surprised if they stick with Sherman the way he was running the ball there from the second quarter on.
Sherman, 7 carries, 54 yards. Matt McHale, 5 for 9, 19 yards, 2 touchdowns. Lehigh's scoring drives, 10 yards, 32 yards. Sherman to the left of McHale, gets the carry on first down, and gets stood up quickly. Good effort by the Lafayette defense. Aloy in there along with Kasha. James Kasha, the leading tackler in the first half with 4.
Now Lehigh's going fast again.
Gain of 2 to the 28. It's 2nd down and 8. McHale will keep this time. McHale out close to the 35-yard line. He'll pick up 6 on the play. It's 3rd down and 2.
Watch the read option here. McHale actually fakes an outside zone to Sherman. He reads the defensive end right there, number 56. If he would have went down for McHale, he would have gave it to Sherman.
3rd and 2. McHale rolling right, throwing short, and again way off target to Josh Paris, who is wide open for a first down.
See, you can't give that up. You cannot win this game if you cannot throw the ball. And again, Lehigh's been good down inside the red zone on a couple passes, but way off on a wide receiver, wide open right there is Matt McHale.
So Divers will have to punt. Kicked it 4 times in the first half, average 45.8. Jared Roberts is back deep at his own 30-yard line for the Leopards. Well, Lehigh missed an opportunity there, and Frank Tavani gets the stop he wanted. Line drive kick. Roberts back at the 20-yard line where he makes the fair catch. A 46-yard punt. Tim Divers has been a big story today for
Lehigh.
Huge
weapon. Huge weapon. Now, I know Andy Cohen said going into halftime, McHale's the guy in the second half. Nick Chepnissi struggled, but he had the ball deep in his own territory. And, you know, he had a bad screen pass that he threw and then tried one across his body. He's 0 for 2. But Matt McHale, 3 of his last 4 passes have just been not even close to the receiver except for the touchdown. He is more composed, but you got to still be able to put the ball on the receiver.
Good first half for the freshman, Drew Reed. 15 for 22 for 248, 2 touchdowns. He was sacked 3 times. Dixon on the screen will step out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. Courtney Jarvis with the coverage, a gain of 7. It's 2nd down and 3.
And Lafayette's defense has taken away that screen pass that Lehigh likes to make their quarterbacks more comfortable, short patterns. They're forcing Lehigh to throw the ball down the field. Lehigh's defense has been giving those bubble and throw out screens to Lafayette, which has been very successful.
4th catch of the day for Dixon. A junior from Conestoga, Pennsylvania. 2nd and 3 for Reed, empty backfield. They fake the sweep to Sherman this time. Reed steps up, delivers down the middle. Ricky Hill had it. Flag is thrown, however, as it looks like Lehigh will be called for pass interference on Ross.
Yeah, it's not going to be on Ricky Hill.
2 flags thrown.
It's going to be on the cornerback that was on the back of Ross.
Pass interference. Defense. Number 28. 15 yards from the original line of scrimmage. First down.
Oliver Rigo.
Okay. I guess the hand did come on the hip there. I've seen more action out there today than that play, Steve.
Again, there are Lehigh fans probably saying Ross's interference that was let go in the first quarter was much worse than that.
Much worse.
Then again, that's a Lehigh fan's perspective.
Then Lafayette got, I think Lehigh got away with one in the first half, too.
15-yard penalty puts the ball to Lafayette, 42, 1st and 10. Here's Sherman, cuts it back to the inside. Very good vision there as he manages to get 4, avoiding the loss. It's 2nd down and 6.
Yeah, it looked like Lehigh had that defended, the outside zone stretch play, but Ross Sherman just cuts back and picks up 4.
Lafayette with a huge advantage in offense in the first half, 279 yards to 98. Sherman again on 2nd down. Fighting, and we'll have a 1st down in Lehigh territory. He is so tough after contact. 1st and 10 at the Lehigh 47-yard line after a gain of 7.
Did a good job there bouncing it to the outside, but still keeping his pads low. squared up his shoulders to the line of scrimmage and just ran downhill.
Sherman from Cambridge, New Jersey, a junior at 6'1", 202 pounds. Closing in at 1,000 yards for the season. Play action this time. Reed rolling right, throwing for Ross. Ross goes up and makes a great catch at the 10-yard line. They'll mark him down at the 12. Ross took a big hit and is not getting up.
Drew Reed just put that ball right where you want it, and he's the difference in this game so far. I think Sherman and Ross, for both Ross Sherman and Keith Sherman, are matching each other running the ball. But look at that pass. That's a great receiver, but he put the ball right where only Ross could get it and took a shot there, but he's okay. Flips off the field.
Tyler Ward delivers the hit. That's 6 catches for Ross for 127 yards. He leaves the field under his own power. First and 10 at the 12. Under center this time. The delay to Sherman. And again, the pile just simply moves forward as he gets 5 more to the 7. It's second down and 5.
Balancing the run and the pass. See if Mark Ross comes back in the game after he limped off. Looks like Ross Sherman's going to come out of the game. Get up a little gingerly after that run.
Sherman shaking up. Marcellus Irving will replace him in the backfield. Irving, a senior, has carried 32 times on the season. Second and 5 at the 7. Paul in motion. Irving in the game, gets the carry. Into the end zone, says Lafayette, and the officials agree. Marcellus Irving, his first touchdown of the year.
Irving's going to get credit with the touchdown, but you got to credit the offensive line for Lafayette. The surge was there. Just a big push up front. Watch the left side of the offensive line. Right there, double teams combo, fullback leading through. Irving in for the touchdown. Started both halves just going all Lafayette's way.
Third quarter's been good for the Leopards. They've outscored their opponents by 37 points as Graylish adds the extra point, and the lead is back to 14. The Leopards banged up on both sides of the football. The backups contribute. Irving from 7 yards out. 11-17 to play third quarter. The Leopards now in front, 28-14. Senior Marcellus Irving, who missed all of the 2011 season with a knee injury. A senior with a big play in a big game, capping off the scoring drive as Lafayette gets the stop against Lehigh, and then Mike marches right down the field.
Yeah, that was a great drive, you know, with the running of Sherman and with that great pass and catch by Mark Ross from Drew Reed. Here you can see Mark Ross isolated going across the field, and I just love where Drew Reed put this ball. They're making more plays. I mean, Lehigh hasn't made a big play outside of the 2 touchdowns, but they were short. Like, they had a long play down the field, an explosive play at all this game. And this has been Lafayette's best special team, their kickoff coverage. Lehigh not getting any good returns here in the ball game.
Graylish to kick off. Courtney Jarvis back deep with Keith Sherman. They've kept it away from Sherman. Lafayette has gone back up by 14 points here early in the third, trying to snap a 5-game losing streak against the Mountain Hawks. Short end over end kick. Jarvis at the 15. Nothing there. 9-yard return to the 24-yard line.
Yeah, it has to get something going on offense right now.
Mike, I'm not saying Lehigh is lacking intensity. I'm saying Lafayette's level is off the charts right now.
Absolutely. They're playing better. They're definitely playing better. And, you know, again, Lehigh's lucky the score is where it is. We talked about that. You don't triple the numbers, which it is now. You know, more than triple the offensive numbers that the Leopards have. And Lehigh's got to do something right now. And number 18's got to carry the load.
344 yards to 108 yards in total offense. Here is Sherman. Sherman will nudge his way across the 25 to the 27, a gain of 3. It's second down and 7.
And Lafayette will take that. 3-4 yards, Sherman can have that, because right now Lehigh has not shown the ability to complete many balls.
Andy Cohen's team trying to come back again, which has been a common theme. Six of the eight wins this year, Lehigh has come from behind. Empty backfield for McHale. Two tight end set. McHale is going to run, and not very far, as Aloy and Robinson shut that down after a gain of a yard. It's third and six.
And you can see the confidence is lacking in the Lehigh coaching staff with their ability to throw the ball. They're a team that likes to stay balanced, and they're trying to establish the run, even the quarterback running. But right now, Matt McHale has got to just throw a three-step drop for a 5-6 yard pickup and get a first down. If I were Lafayette, I would challenge. I'd press up on the receivers and say, go for it.
Matt Smalley back in a corner for Lehigh. Up for Lafayette, pardon me, number 24 in white, back for the Leopards. McHale throws to Sergio Fernandez Soto, who makes the catch and has the first down at the 36-yard line. Fernandez Soto missed several games with a hamstring. He came back last week and makes a big catch right there.
Well, he was poised there, McHale was. He stayed in the pocket, waited for Soto to get open, first down. Might have to throw the ball on first down a little bit here, too. And that crowd in the box against Sherman.
Give is to Sherman on first down. He'll weave his way and lose the football at the 40-yard line. Lafayette says it has it. Lehigh has had trouble with turnovers all year. And the Leopards recover the football at the 40. Jared Roberts has the football for Lafayette.
Been no turnovers in this ball game. Am I correct, Steve? The ball's been on the ground a couple times, but no turnovers. And now Lafayette can really, really put pressure on Lehigh as the strip, it looked like the strip came from Boyles, who was in on the tackle. Watch him shed the block 52 off of Tyler Coyle, strips the ball out.
Neither team has been great in the turnover game. Lafayette is now minus five. Lehigh is minus eight on the air. Irving stays in at tailback, and Marcellus will get hit after a yard gain to the 40. It's second down and nine.
The power went out at Goodman Stadium in the third quarter, and during that break, Ross Shurman punched in his second touchdown of the day, another one-yard run to make it 36-14. The power returned to the stadium early in the fourth quarter, just as Nick Shafnisky found Tyler Coyle for a seven-yard touchdown to get Lehigh within two scores.
We welcome you back to Goodman Stadium in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. We apologize for our technical difficulties. About 25% of the stadium lost power. We have just started the fourth quarter in the 149th meeting of Lehigh and Lafayette. While we were gone, Ross Sherman scored on a one-yard run for Lafayette and on a bad snap on the extra point. On a scramble, the holder Blake Searfoss got in for the two-point conversion. It was 36-14 Lafayette after three quarters. On the first play of the fourth quarter, Nick Shafnisky threw a seven-yard touchdown pass to tight end Tyler Coyle. Ryan Pandy's extra point brings Lehigh back within 15 at 36-21. Shafnisky was in because Matt McHale, the Lehigh quarterback, lost his helmet on the last play of the third quarter and by rule must sit out a play. Shafnisky comes in, throws the touchdown to Coyle, Tyler's second catch of the afternoon. So we are early in the fourth, 14:56 to go in a game that Lafayette has dominated. Lehigh trying to hang around, trailing 36-21 with the winner taking the Patriot League title and advancing to the NCAA playoffs next weekend. Pandy to kick off. Then he'll hook one out of bounds for the second time today and the fourth time in the last 2 weeks. So Lafayette will have it first and 10 at the 35-yard line.
He's just momentum shifts. You know, they get a little momentum and the kicker comes in and kicks it out of bounds. It's a big field out there. It's over 50 yards across and he's got to figure that out. But I think that botch extra point really has a lot. You know, and then Lafayette taking it in, the holder scrambling in, making it a two-score game. Plus, Lehigh needs a two-point conversion. They elected not to chase the points as they just scored before that kickoff.
So now the Lehigh defense has to make a play.
Lafayette really controlled the clock their last possession. And it's with the running game right here.
This will be the first carry of the afternoon for Greg Kessel, a senior from East Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania. As they'll try and control clock here. And what an afternoon it's been for freshman quarterback Drew Reed, the first Lafayette freshman QB to start in this game since Marco Glavich in 2000. Second down and 7 for the Leopards.
Lehigh not stopped, didn't stop Lafayette much today. It's almost Lafayette stopped themselves. The only few times they had to punt.
Reed is 19 for 26 for 310 yards and 2 touchdowns. And we've had very few whistles here in the second half.
Lehigh's coaching staff still on the field. Their coordinators had to run down to the field when the power outage was up here. They lost connection. I think I see Gerald Wiltshire still down there communicating with Donnie Roberts.
They are the co-defensive coordinators for Lehigh.
The tough part is you don't know personnel coming in, being down there, not having connection. There you can see Donnie Roberts.
Second down and 12 after the procedure penalty. Kessel stays in at running back. He'll get his second straight carry. Short gain to the 36-yard line. Brings up a third down and 9. Now let's see how conservative Lafayette might or might not be in this situation.
I don't think they're gonna. I think Drew Reese done a great job, especially finding Mark Ross and Justin Adams, who's had a really good game.
But 5 catches for 92 yards. Ross 6 catches for 127.
Now, last time in this situation, when we were away with the power outage, Lafayette brought a screen pass. Lehigh, if they want to bring pressure, still have to be aware of any type of screen, probably coming from one of the wideouts because they have their bigger back in the backfield.
3rd and 9. Low snap. Reed handles it. Lehigh bringing pressure. Noah Robb, what a big sack last week. And Colby gets one here. Sophomore from Allentown Central Catholic High School. Lafayette will have to punt.
Drew Reed did a good job tucking that ball away. Nobody open downfield, good coverage. And right here, Noah Robb comes off and he's trying to strip that ball out. Drew Reed had to tuck it away. Josh Parrish deep. Lafayette did have one punt blocked earlier in the ball game.
3 sacks on the year for Robb. 4th sack of the day for Lehigh. Forrester has punted 3 times, 24 yards a kick. Knox coming again. Forrester gets it off. Parrish at the 40 on the run. Breaks 1 tackle. It'll be dragged down at the 47-yard line. We'll step aside. A lot of time left. Can Lehigh come back for the 7th time this year? 12-16 to play in the 4th. The Mountain Knox trail 36-21. Nick Schafnisky will stay in at quarterback for Lehigh after throwing a touchdown pass to start the 4th quarter. Lehigh, great field position, 1st and 10 at its own 47-yard line, down by 15 points, and the Mountain Hawks will move back 5 as they will be penalized for illegal procedure.
Prior to snap, false start, 70. 5 yards from the original line of scrimmage, 1st down.
Mike, I think you brought up a good point, actually a couple of times today. Lehigh has not been able to seize momentum and keep it. Something happens that kind of gets them off kilter.
And this is the first time they scored, and actually the defense then stopped Lafayette. And, you know, they have the opportunity to seize momentum and then the penalty to start the drive.
So now it's 1st and 15.
I wouldn't be surprised if Lehigh play actions and goes up top. Haven't taken many shots.
Schafnisky is 1 for 3 for 7 yards and the touchdown. Not much for the freshman here. Both Shermans, Ross for Lafayette, Keith for Lehigh, over 100 yards rushing today, and both now over 1,000 yards for the season. So congratulations to Keith Sherman out of Lawrence High School outside of Trenton, New Jersey. Had a chance to be in contact with his high school coach, Rob Braddis, earlier this week. Couldn't say enough things about the person and player and leader that Keith Sherman is. Second and 15. There is Keith Sherman. He'll get 3 of them back. 3rd down and 12 with 11 and a half minutes to play.
I guess Lehigh's, you know, thinking they're down 2 scores, but 11 and a half to go still. If they have to punt, they will punt them deep.
Lee Kerfus has caught 4 passes today. That gives him 96, tying the Lehigh single season record set by Ryan Spadola, the All-American now on the Miami Dolphins practice squad, who had 96 catches in 2011.
Yeah, it's got to make a play here. They haven't had this spark on like a 3rd and long. You've seen it out of the Lafayette offense. Let's see if Nick Schafnisky can make something happen.
Empty backfield, four-man rush. The throw for Purvis. There's the Lehigh record, and there's a first down at the 32-yard line.
And we haven't seen that once today. I mean, how many times have we seen Lee Corpus catch a dig across the middle of the last 2 years? And right there, Nick Shefniski with good protection. Corpus sticks it, finds the window. First down, Lehigh.
Gain of 22 yards. They'll mark him down at the 33. That is a Lehigh record 97th catch of the season for Lee Corpus. Still 10 and a half minutes to play.
Coverage down here. They could go up top to Kerfus.
He's being picked up by Smalley. The get is to Sherman. It's a reverse to Paris. Paris is going to throw to a wide open Shefniski, and it was underthrown and incomplete inside the 20-yard line.
Josh Paris threw a ball last week on a reverse to Lee Kerfus, and right there, Shefniski not able to control his body to come back. He's running straight, and it's underthrown. It was there.
That pass you talked about last week went for 38 yards. This one off the mark. Would have been six for sure. Instead, it's second and 10 at the 33-yard line. Andy Cohen wants a timeout before the play clock expires. That's a timeout you may need on defense later in the game. 36-21. Lafayette, before you head out to your next Lehigh event, be sure to stop into the Lehigh University Bookstore for the latest merchandise, including shirts, hats, and much more. The Lehigh Bookstore is now open 7 days a week and is located at Campus Square on Morton and New Streets. Now, Mike Lehigh, uncharacteristically, has missed a lot of open receivers today, trick play or not. Yep. Last one could have been a touchdown. Quick look at the out-of-town scoreboard. Georgetown looking to take down Holy Cross in the season finale, up by two touchdowns. Fordham trying to finish at 10-1 all over Colgate, and VMI is leading Bucknell by a field goal in the third. Second down and 10 for the Mountain Hawks. McHale is back in a quarterback. Throws a quick out for Sergio Fernandez Soto, who dives for a first down at the 22-yard line, a pickup of 11 for the Mountain Hawks.
I think they pulled Shefniski because Andy Cole was upset that he didn't see the play clock. He was definitely upset he had to use that timeout.
McHale gives to Sherman, has a hole, cuts it back at the 15, spins close to another first down.
There's a nice play, run the ball a little bit. It's not panic, definitely throw. Lehigh's going fast, I see Sherman carry this again.
McHale rolling, Fernandez Soto couldn't hang on, drailing. James able to reach in and knock it away at the last second.
Yeah, Draylen James made a nice play right here. Pretty good ball. And watch Draylen James punch that right arm. Lehigh's got to pick up the first down here. You got two downs to get the first down.
Third down and two. McHale will not get close. Fourth and two.
Could be the ball game right here.
Mike, what have you seen from Lafayette that for the most part Lehigh's quarterback runs have had very little success?
They just look fast to the ball. You know, but the team, Lehigh's team looks slower down there on both sides of the ball today. And right here, it's fourth down and two. You gotta think, I'm thinking Lehigh's probably gonna play action pass here.
Lehigh is 13 for 18 on fourth down, 72%, eighth best in the country. The give is to Sherman, first down, five, goal line, touchdown, the Shermanator scores against the Leopards again.
Well, maybe Lafayette was thinking what I was thinking, play action pass, they run the little counter, follows his fullback around, Zach Hayden gets a pancake in there on the linebacker. Lehigh's going to elect to go for the 1 point, extra point, put them down by 8.
Handy's kick is up, and it is good. Lehigh right back in it with 8:49 to play, down by 8 points. Keith Sherman with a tremendous individual effort. 36-28, Lafayette with the lead here in the fourth quarter in Bethlehem. Lafayette by 8, time for a look at our Alvin H. Butts game recap here in the fourth quarter. It's been a very impressive day for Lafayette quarterback Drew Reed.
Yeah, he's been great. Hasn't made any mistakes. He hasn't turned the ball over yet today. And Lehigh's defense really struggling. The only positive for Lehigh defense has been in the sack category. They have 4 on the day, led by Caswell, the freshman.
Now, Lehigh has been in this situation before the last 2 seasons. Double-digit deficits they've overcome 6 times in the last 2 years, including the opener this year here at Goodman Stadium. They trailed Central Connecticut State by 20 points in the fourth quarter and came back to win in double overtime.
Well, it starts here. The comeback is going to continue. Lehigh's got to keep this ball in bounds. And is Tim Divers out there kicking now? I'm not sure.
It's Pandy.
It's still Pandy. And they got a cover to kick.
Keith Sherman, 2 years ago, a 52-yard touchdown run to open the scoring here against Lafayette. Last year, a 14-yard touchdown catch to put Lehigh ahead in the second half. He has had some big plays against the Leopards. This will be Sherman from the 6-yard line, straight ahead. And he's tripped up across the 30. So Lafayette will have decent field position with 8:44 to play, leading by 8. If you're wondering, should Lehigh get a hold here and get a score, Mike? The Mountain Hawks are 0-for-3 on 2-point conversions this season.
I was wondering.
Here is Reed, the 6-foot freshman from Lakeland, Tennessee, with 70 touchdowns in his 3-year high school career. He'll throw it out for Dixon. This has been a play that has worked for the Leopards. Dixon makes a couple of nice moves and is off to the races. Demetrius Dixon is going to take a screen pass inside the 15 and into the end zone. 68 yards for a touchdown.
Demetrius Dixon, that was all him. He gets a block on the outside, but then when he cuts back against the grain, right here, Lehigh looks like they have a defender. He picks up right there. Watch this. Cuts back against the grain. Boom. The pursuit is broken down. He gets one last block for Mark Ross. Here you see it again, dancing left, dancing right. And then he just puts the burners on after getting this last block by Mark Ross.
Dixon's 3rd touchdown catch of the season. It's the 3rd thrown by Reed, who looks to be a lock to be a freshman quarterback MVP in the Lehigh Lafayette game. It took all of 20 seconds for Lafayette to answer, as Grealish makes it 43-28. We just talked about it seemingly 5 minutes ago. Lehigh again unable to maintain any type of momentum.
Yeah, absolutely. Or give credit to Lafayette.
Absolutely.
Answering the bell.
Absolutely. Give Lafayette the credit.
Seize the momentum. And Andy Cohen just, you know, besides himself, because we got the momentum. We got everything. The defense is fired up. And hey, Dixon just made a play. You know, I really got to give that young man credit, because Lehigh was flying to the football, almost maybe too much flying to the football. And he made some moves, and but Lehigh's got to score quick.
Mike, things looking a little bleak right now for the Mountain Hawks, who have won 5 straight in the series. They did not get an at-large bid last year at 10-1 after not winning the Patriot League. It would seem to be impossible that they'd even be considered 8-3 this year, wouldn't it?
Yeah, because Lafayette's going to get the automatic in Fordham, even though they weren't eligible this year because of the scholarships. They will be next year in Fordham, but as a ranked team, will probably get a bid. So for the Patriot League to get 3, that's a real long shot.
So Lehigh has 8:29 left to try and pull out a miracle here.
Now, they did expand the field this year. Did
true.
The number of teams that are in the
24.
They need a play. They need a big play. You know, Lafayette has by far made the big plays, the long games, as you just saw.
Lehigh has missed in their opportunities. The pass off the reverse, which was a really good touchdown. Lafayette going to the 3rd and 2 for big yardage. Jarvis at the 3. It's around the outside. Gets by the kicker, Jarvis. Jarvis will muscle his way out to the 40-yard line. A good effort by Courtney Jarvis, the architecture major from Temple Hills, Maryland.
Lehigh needs to give themselves a chance. They need to move the sticks here and get a touchdown. Allow their defense one more shot to try to stop Lafayette. Down by 15, you only have 2 timeouts because you had to burn one on their last drive. But they've got to be, they can't go for everything on one shot. If they see it there, go for it. But got to move the sticks, keep going fast, get in the end zone.
PLN at quarterback. Goes to Kerfus on that slant. Kerfus will pick up 8 to the Lehigh 49. 2nd down and 2. Mike, if you score, do you give the defense a chance or do you try to get the onside kick?
No, you give the defense a chance. Depends how much time's left, I guess.
Sherman cuts it back. Appears to have the 1st down, slipping inside Lafayette territory. To the 48-yard line, he will move the chains. 1st and 10 for the Mountain Hawks.
I go back to that slant play, 2 plays ago. I really like that because it gives Curtis a shot to even break it. We've seen him break the tackle and go the distance on those plays.
8 minutes to play. Lehigh down by 15.
Lehigh has not run the wheel in the back of the backfield today yet.
McHale spreading out, throwing, and broken up by Smalley. The intended receiver was the tight end Tyler Coyle, who has 2 touchdown catches today. McHale probably should have kept that ball. Mike, he had a lot of room in front.
Same thing, Steve. He definitely could have probably picked up the 1st down and maybe some and then got out of bounds, but he kept his eyes downfield and forced that pass a little bit. You'll see it right here. Container's broken. He could take off right there. Throws it into traffic.
2nd and 10 for the Mountain Hawks.
Still run the ball here. I think you're in 4-down territory.
Pressure from the backside. Tyrus White forces the fumble, and Lafayette will scoop it up. Kasha is going to go in untouched from 42 yards to seal it for the Leopards. Tyrus White, the speed rusher at the end.
James Kasha, very aware as that ball is bouncing around. Scoops and scores, takes it down, and you said he just sealed it for the Lafayette Leopards. Matt McHale does not see the pressure. There's the strip. Kasha takes his time, picks it up.
And walk into the end zone. Turnovers have hurt the Mountain Hawks all year. They were better the last 2 weeks, plus 4. But a couple of big ones here this afternoon. Grealish to put Lafayette at the 50-point mark. Tyrus White gets cut and then gets right back up, Mike, and look at the speed.
Yeah, he was really good, and he knew he had a shot to strip that ball, so he wrapped with his left, he stripped with his right, and James Kasha goes down the sideline for the score.
Lafayette is going to get the automatic bid to the NCAA playoffs out of the Patriot League despite a 1-5 start and a losing record overall. They'll be 5-6. They will be playing somewhere next week. It is now time to check in on the Lehigh Lafayette Alumni Giving Challenge. The results are in, and Lafayette has been declared the winner in that as well. Congratulations to the Leopards. For more information on the challenge, visit llchallenge.com. Frank Tavani, he told me earlier this week, Mike, he said, I had to keep my players and my staff together after a 1-5 start. Said that we had to tune out all the outside noise. He freely admitted, he said, the alumni were calling for my head. And he said, Andy Cohen knows what that situation was like. He was in it a few years ago. He said, we had to stay together as a unit, and we had to fight our way back. And they have done that, and they'll be, it appears, barring a major collapse, heading to the postseason next week.
Yeah, they're going to go in, and they've done this before. They've actually won the league, I believe, with a losing record once before.
And Frank Tavani really credited his seniors and their leadership for holding the team together. He said the head coach always takes the heat, but the seniors have been committed to the program. And he said at 1-5, we were the only people who expected us to play for a Patriot League title. Will kick one out of bounds, and Lehigh will get the ball at the 35-yard line with 7:29 to play. Right, we talked coming right out of the shoot today that coach is always worried about it. A game like this where have the teams used up all their energy in practice? Did they leave it in the locker room? Andy Cohen said, we've been ready to play this game since Sunday. Lafayette has had the energy and has maintained the energy all day long.
And they made plays. I never question as we watch this first down for Lehigh. I'll get back to my point.
Chafnisky is back in at quarterback. An empty backfield on first down. In some trouble.
Throw it away. Yeah, that's because he's out of the pocket and he throws a pass out of scrimmage. And my point was, you know, some people, well, they didn't come to play. They didn't come. I really think both teams come to play. It's a matter of making plays. Lafayette made plays. They made plays on offense. They made plays on defense. They made plays. Lehigh didn't make many plays. Outside of the block field goal, block extra point, again, there were no big explosive plays on offense. They actually had a chance on the reverse pass. They didn't make the play. Lafayette has made all the plays in all the phases of the game.
Lafayette gets a lot of the credit for the way they have performed here today. They snap this five-game losing streak, it appears, to their arch rival. Chafnisky again looking around. Incomplete for Kirkus. Third down and 10.
And Lafayette usually is a little blitz happy with John Wilson's defense. But right now, they're just letting their guys cover. You know, they haven't rushed a whole lot today. They said, we're going to bring four and make you find the spot. Quarterbacks aren't missing paint on their helmet. He hasn't played a lot.
The Lafayette sideline, as you would expect. Pretty excited right now. Players over there. Here comes White off the edge again. Screen to Paris, well off the mark. Fourth and 10.
Does Lehigh just punt here? And basically wave the white flag, or do they go for it on fourth and 10? Then you have 7:09 to play. You've got to just give yourself a shot. Go for it. Now throw the ball downfield.
Lehigh will go for it on fourth and 10.
Finally, Kirkus is isolated down here. They're playing safeties over the top. Man underneath.
Trying a three-man rush. Trips to the left for the Mountain Hawks. Chafnisky throws for Kirkus. Kirkus makes the catch and will have a first down at the Lafayette 38-yard line. Lee Kirkus with a great grab.
Wow. It looked like that might be intercepted. There's pretty good coverage out there by Jared Roberts. Lee Kirkus tries to get in the middle of that zone. There's the safety over the top. Roberts, Chafnisky put it in the seam.
99th catch of the year for Lee Kirkus. Here is Keith Sherman, over 1,000 for the year. He'll have another first down to the 27-yard line. 6:50 to go. Kirkus is two catches away from tying the Patriot League single-season record. Chafnisky running on first down again. There's not very much there for the Lehigh quarterback. Pickup of a yard.
Now, there's been a little something there when they pull it on the read, but for the when they call the quarterback powers, the quarterback outside zones, there's nothing there. He has got to try to move faster here.
Almost 6.5 minutes to play, down by 22 points.
Buckets continues to keep safety over the top.
Chafnisky, look right, look left, nobody open. intercepted. Smalley at the 15-yard line. Another Lehigh turnover, and Smalley will be tackled by Josh Paris at the 27.
That was bound to happen. Lafayette to sit in coverage. Only a three-man rush. Chapnisky forces the ball. Smalley, who left the game earlier with an injury, comes up with an interception, and now it's just a matter of running the clock out for the Leopards.
Fourth interception of the year for the sophomore man, Smalley.
He's looking, rolls, he's looking, and right here. And that was doomed from the time it left his hands.
Under center, I formation now with Irving the tailback. Marcellus gets the carry on first down. Mike has talked about big plays for the Leopards, and here is proof positive.
Well, this is 4th and 26. This is their second touchdown of the game. Lehigh didn't like the non-call and the push-off, but they still made the play. This is 3rd and short in the first half. They run a flea flicker, get it down to Adams, which sets up another touchdown. Here was just a simple screen play. And Demetrius Dixon, using his legs, his moves, picks up a block. Another big play. And then why not the defense making a big play? The strip from behind, the scoop and score. James Kosha takes it down for 6.
Lafayette has actually taken 2 fumbles into the end zone today. One was their own at the 1-yard line to start the scoring, and that was Lehigh's. Kosha returned it. Here's Irving. He'll be a yard shy at the 35-yard line. Frank Tavani has lost 5 straight to Lehigh coming into today. His team coming off what he called the most complete performance, even though Reed threw 4 interceptions last week. They beat number 5 Fordham, albeit with the Rams using a backup quarterback, but they have carried that into today. It was the highest ranked opponent that Lafayette had beaten in school history. They will get their first Patriot League title since 2006, as Irving will have the first down.
But I've been to Lafayette. Guys will say, and I read somewhere in print, that, you know, they were missing their quarterback for him, but I didn't see anybody on the defense missing. And, you know, Lafayette really looked good on offense last week, and they continued it today. And Lafayette, people also tell you, you know, over there, they're a little disappointed in their record this year. And some people on the flip side might be a little stunned that Lehigh's record was as good as it was with some of the close games they had and all the, you know, the positions that they lost from last year and some good players and then the quarterback situation. But this is a game that matters for most Lehigh people. And, you know, the record, even though 8-3 is not a bad record.
This will be a rare loss under Andy Cohen when Lehigh rushes for better than 100 yards. They have 179 yards on the ground today. Mike, in Andy Cohen's 8 years, they have now rushed for 100 yards in a game 62 times, including today. They have lost only 15 of those games.
Yeah, it took them a while to get that running game today. The offense completely shut down in the first quarter. Then they got Keith Sherman going a little bit in the second quarter, but again, you know, you said it over and over, they were never able to totally get the momentum swing in their favor. And Lafayette answered the bell 90% of the time in this game.
This will be the 4th straight time that Lafayette will win this matchup when the Patriot League title is on the line. First championship for the Leopards since 2006. It'll be the 7th in school history. They're not using Ross Sherman, who was banged up earlier. He'll be playing next week, so they're going with Marcellus Irving.
Yeah, Lafayette will definitely be going on the road somewhere.
Probably won't be a real favorable opponent with a 5-6 record,
correct,
but they're in it. And they've made some noise in the FCA playoffs in the past, as has Lehigh.
Frank Tavani's got to be really happy with that freshman quarterback, Drew Reed. I was really impressed with his composure today. And, you know, they've only lost 1 game since he's been thrown in there.
Frank Tavani said at halftime of the Harvard game, I'd made up my mind. He said, we had thrown too many interceptions. This kid's getting a chance, and he left me no choice with the way he played in the second half and then the following week at Holy Cross when he threw 5 touchdown passes.
And on the flip side, Lehigh hasn't been the same since Brandon Mayakowski went out. I understand they won a couple big games in there. You know, they beat Holy Cross, went up to Colgate, but it wasn't the same play they got from Brandon Bajakowski, who was, you know, one of the tops in the country, is the way the senior quarterback threw the ball this year. Lafayette, it was decisions to pull the guys. Lehigh, it was a decision of injury, and then, as you can see today, Lehigh not sure what quarterback they wanted out there. They went with the junior, stuck the freshman in, both did some nice things, did some poor things, and it's going to be an interesting offseason for the quarterback battle next year.
Bajakowski threw for 2,647 yards and 18 touchdowns before that injury against Bucknell. Irving again. Bring up a third down and two. Cody Condis, a sophomore from Westerville, Ohio, on the tackle for the Mountain Hawks with a minute and a half to play here in Bethlehem.
It's been an odd game. Power outage. Big plays, wacky plays. But I definitely, I think everybody agrees in the stadium, a dominant performance by Lafayette.
They've been inconsistent, but when they've brought this team to the field, they've been awfully tough to beat. 1-5 start is for Gotts. Down to seal it. They'll have to snap it one or two more times before the celebration will begin in Easton. They'll snap it once more. Champions of the Patriot League in 2013 with a 5-6 record. They will move on and represent the Patriot League in the FCS playoffs next week. Lafayette came storming out of the gate. A 52-yard kickoff return by Ross Sherman set them up. Sherman will recover a fumble inside the five and take it into the game's first touchdown. Then Mark Ross on a 4th and 26 would catch a 31-yard touchdown pass to make it 14-0. And Lehigh tried to play catch up from there. Got within 7 a couple of times, trailed 21-14 at halftime. But Nigel Muhammad, a senior, and his team could not complete the comeback today. And season and careers will come to an end today for several Mountain Hawks.
Yeah, there's a lot of passion out there on both sides. And it keeps the rivalry going. You know, Lehigh was on a roll for years, and Lafayette won a bunch in a row. And now Lehigh's won 5 in a row. Lafayette comes back, and now they win a big one and a dominating performance. And all of a sudden, we're gonna wake up soon, and we're going to be in Yankee Stadium for the 150th game a year from now.
How about that, young man? Freshman Drew Reed. As Frank Tavani told me, he said, "Coach, I don't get nervous. He doesn't get too excited one way or the other." He was extremely impressive here this afternoon.
Yeah, absolutely. Not the biggest guy. You can see he looks like a freshman. Little baby face in there, but
he's going to have to ask for a ride home.
Absolutely. Yeah, Holy Cross played a freshman. Lehigh played some freshmen. With the addition of scholarships, the Patriot League's just going to get better and better. And you're going to see in the next couple of years a lot of freshmen, sophomores be on the field for every team in this league.
Lehigh lost that game to Bucknell in late October. Everybody stunned. 48-10, the Bison with the win. It's a game Lehigh certainly would love to have back. They had won 15 in a row over Bucknell. It made this game extremely relevant with both teams coming in at 3-1. And Lafayette took advantage. The Mountain Hawks thought they had gotten a wake-up call in that game, Mike. The seniors rallied. They beat Holy Cross. They beat Colgate on the road last week. They just couldn't pull it off today.
Absolutely. Just again, credit to Lafayette for making the plays.
Well, Drew Reed coming into this game, first freshman to start at quarterback against Lehigh since 2000, and he didn't do too much wrong today, Mike.
No, his passes were right there. No mistakes, giving guys opportunities, off the flea flicker. And I still think his most impressive pass of the day. Well, here you can see some of the simple swing pass for a touchdown. It's a screen play for the huge touchdown that really took away any chance Lehigh had of winning this game. That one from Dixon.
Well, Mike, let me ask you maybe a dumb question to some, but you played in this game. You know what it's all about. Might it be easier for a freshman to play in this game? Because even though you hear about all the hype, you've never really experienced it. When you're a senior, you know what it's like because you've been there three times.
You got a good point, but I don't want to say it's easier, but you might not think about, you can't envision what it's going to be like, but I just think he did a good job, and I think his teammates helped him out a lot. You know, they made good plays for him. He did what they asked him to do. He didn't turn the ball over, and let's see what he has to say.
Well, let's find out from Drew Reed himself as he's standing by down in the field with Troy Hine. Troy?
All right, guys, thanks very much. Drew, talk a little bit about how much fun this was as a freshman to come here and play like this and get a win for Lafayette.
You know, it's huge. It's huge for our seniors. It's huge for our upperclassmen. You know, they've worked really hard for this, and this being their first win against Lehigh, you know, they've really deserved it. It's a big game for them, and I'm just glad we were able to get a win.
When you look back at this game and the coming out of the tunnel and everything as a freshman, what are you going to remember most?
Just that we won is what I remember most. You know, these seniors are a great group of guys, you know, on and off the field. Like I said, they've worked really hard for it, and they're really deserving. And, you know, I was glad we were able to get it done for them.
You've played awfully well the last several weeks. What is it about this offense that's really kind of worked for you guys over the last several weeks to get the Patriot League Championship?
You know, the coaches put a great game plan for us each and every week. They put it out in front of us. You know, if we just try not to do too much, me in particular, you know, we can be very explosive offensively if we just play within ourselves and not try to do too much, like I said.
Has it sunk in what you've accomplished on this day as a freshman here at Lehigh University?
I try not to think about, you know, my grade and stuff like that. I just try to play the best I can, and, you know, it'll sink in more as I think about it looking back. But, you know, it's a huge win for us.
All right, you guys are going to the FCS playoffs. You don't know where or when yet, but you know that you're going.
Right.
What is that like for you?
You know, it's huge. It's huge. Like I said, it's huge for these seniors. You know, they've never made the playoffs, and they've worked really hard for 4 years, and I'm just glad us as a team were able to get it done and just lead them to the playoffs.
Congratulations on a big win. Thanks for your time. Appreciate it. Yep, absolutely. Guys, back to you.
All right, Troy's got a pretty good grip on that game ball. Justin Adams, guy who's been saddled with injuries throughout the season, he played a big part in this victory as well for Lafayette today. And Mike, you kind of mentioned it's going to be an interesting offseason for Lehigh. Matt McHale is a junior. Nick Shefniski is a freshman. Both played a quarterback today. The Mountain Hawks certainly had a good season at 8-3. But the goals are win the Patriot League Championship, beat Lafayette, get to the playoffs. They did not accomplish that, unfortunately, this season.
No, they didn't. And they arguably had better teams the last 2 years. And last year, they didn't even get to play for the championship because of the home loss to Colgate before the Lafayette game. But, you know, they have something to build on. They have 6-7 starters back on both sides of the ball. Good guys up front. You know, they really defense struggled most of the year. Outside of the last two games, Holy Cross and the game up at Colgate, their defense has been pretty porous, and then came out here today and the defense struggled against Lafayette's offense. Well, they're going to have most of their guys back in that front seven, which really carried them for those championships years. So there's something to build on, but it's college football. Every team's good. Every coaching staff's good. Everybody's prepared, and sometimes things go your way. And I think we saw this early on. The kick return, and then the ball fumbled and bounces back into Sherman's hands, and he takes it in for a six. And Lehigh was looking back from the very beginning.
And isn't it ironic, I guess, in some aspects, that the two Patriot League losses for Lehigh really were started with the opening kickoff of the game? You can't always say that. Lehigh fumbled the opening kickoff at Bucknell. The Bison took it in and rolled to a 48-10 win. Today, Ross Sherman takes the opening kick, 52 yards, sets up a short field. And Lafayette, even though Lehigh played hard, tried to come back a couple of times, Lafayette really just took control from that point.
Yeah, I agree with you. You know, the momentum is so big in a game like this, and when you hand the team pretty much points at the beginning and you're playing catch up from the beginning, it changes your mantra, your attitude, and everything, you know, that you're battling uphill throughout the game.
Well, if you joined us late, first of all, you missed a power outage in the third quarter, but you've missed maybe a lot of big plays today. We'll show them to you again as Lafayette really came through in some big situations. This was a 4th-and-26. Mark Ross catches a 31-yard touchdown pass, and then some trickery worked out as well.
3rd-and-short, they go with the flea flicker, and Justin Adams sets up the next touchdown.
And they throw out a screen to Demetrius Dixon. It's a play they ran a lot today, but not like this. It goes 68 yards for a touchdown. You talk about Mark Ross, and he was a factor today, but guys like Adams and Dixon really played a big part in this game. James Kasha returned a fumble 42 yards for a touchdown as Lafayette led the entire way and snaps a five-game losing streak in this series against Lehigh. And the Mountain Hawks will not finish undefeated here at home for the first time since 2001 as Lafayette rolls to a 22-point victory. 50-28, the final here today. So a tough one today for the Mountain Hawks. They will finish their season at 8-3, 3-2 in the Patriot League. They came in ranked as high as 15th in the country in the FCS. Lafayette's regular season ends with a losing record at 5-6, but most importantly, 4-1 in the Patriot League, champions and the automatic qualifiers to the FCS playoffs, which begin next week. Lafayette snaps a five-game losing streak against Lehigh with a convincing win here this afternoon at Goodman Stadium. That'll do it for Mike Yadish and our entire crew. This is Steve Degler saying thanks so much for watching and so long from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. We hope you have a great Thanksgiving and holiday season. A tough one for the Mountain Hawks today, but they are celebrating in Easton, Pennsylvania as Lafayette gets the victory and the Patriot League Championship. The final score once again from Bethlehem, Lafayette 50, Lehigh 28. So long from Goodman Stadium.